We're on river time now. So we eat when we're hungry, we stop when we want to, we go to bed when we want to, and this is your trip.
On the Rogue's 40th anniversary is a wild and scenic river. There's a proposal to log in its drainage, and a group called Save the Wild Rogue is working to make sure that doesn't happen by extending wild and scenic protection to its tributary streams. Not a bad birthday present for one of the oldest conserved rivers in the nation, and that proposal is what we've come to investigate.
Well, good morning. My name's Kyle Dickman from the Epicocity Project. We spent 2007-2008 traveling abroad. We went to Papua New Guinea, China, and the Democratic Republic of Congo.
Each one of the locations that we visited was to investigate why these drainages were threatened. So when we found out that there was a proposal to log on our backyard run, we wanted to include the Rogue into our Rivers in Demand project in hopes of getting this river the protection it deserves.
Starting right here at the Grave Creek Bridge is the Wild and Scenic, which means no motorized vehicles, very limited development. So it sort of starts a very pristine river corridor from here on down.
Our plan was a four-day float down the Wild and Scenic Corridor through southern Oregon's Siskiyou Mountains. At Rainy Falls, a 10-foot waterfall where if the season is right and you catch a bit of luck, you can watch 45-pound salmon hurl themselves into the maw of whitewater. It used to be that you couldn't avoid these fish, but things have changed. There are fewer fish. This is Kavita Heyn of American Rivers.
The salmon migration corridors in the Rogue River are a real attraction for the commercial fishing industry. The industry itself provides millions of dollars of economic output for Josephine County and also for the state of Oregon.
Guys, so this is Whiskey Creek Cabin, and we're gonna take a little walk up. It's about a quarter mile to a third of a mile.
This is Whiskey Creek. It is a tributary stream that is proposed for inclusion under the Wild and Scenic Rivers Act, and it is an incredible steelhead spawning stream. You've got cold water running off a mountain through primarily old growth forests. So you can see that there's a lot of juvenile congregating around where this tributary flows into the main stem. About 100,000 salmon return to the Rogue River every year to spawn. Each and every one of these fish need the cool waters the Rogue's tributaries provide in order to successfully spawn.
And it isn't just the salmon and the wildlife. It's a river corridor full of human history. Gold miners' cabins are edged into the hills, their Native American village grounds, frequently used campsites, and a museum that honors the life of the early settlers. By our third day on the river, I understand this river corridor as something missing in most of the American West. It's a landscape where man has benefited from its use for centuries, but has not abused it. Despite the frequency of human visitors on the river itself, the reason the Rogue has remained so healthy is because of the vibrance of the land surrounding it. And I see that as at the core of what Save the Wild Rogue is trying to protect.
I'm here with my husband. It's his sabbatical. So we took a wild trip, and it has been magical. Because it's the spirit of the place, you know, there's just so much good energy, and it makes you really feel alive. It's a very vital place.
A lot of people have asked me, how does logging that I can't even see affect the health of the lower Rogue? Well, when you remove the trees,
you remove the shade. Temperatures in the tributaries rise, and you make it virtually impossible for salmon to successfully spawn.
Which means, if logging does take place in a few of these tributaries, the 100,000 salmon that return each year will have fewer places to spawn. And the way that I see it, man will have abused its relationship with the land.
You can't just pick and choose the easiest or the prettiest. Sometimes you gotta protect the non-charismatic parts, the little bugs, the little tiny ephemeral streams that not everybody gets a chance to see. You've gotta protect all the pieces, Aldo Leopold once said.
If getting a few more tributaries into Wild and Scenic protection is the way to ensure that and keep the $13 million the Lower Rogue brings to Southern Oregon in Southern Oregon, maybe it's time to add just one more layer of protection to this marvelous river.
Rogue is one of Oregon's and the nation's most iconic rivers, and we now need your help to protect the Rogue and its fish-bearing streams. Contact your congressional representatives or senators and encourage them to protect this very special river system through Wild and Scenic designation. Visit our website to get involved and use your voice to save the Wild Rogue.